Hello, I'm Varni Batugahage from Sri Lanka. In this presentation, I'm going to discuss what is meant by donatio mortis causa. It is considered as an exception for the rule in constitution mentioned in Milroy against Lord case law. Donatio mortis causa is a gift which was made in contemplation of the death. That means the donor is making the gift when he was living during his lifetime, but the gift will come into existence only after his death. So therefore we will not recognize it as a testamentary gift or an inter vivos gift. It is neither a testamentary nor inter vivos gift. However, this will be working as an exception for the rule in Milroy against Lord, as an exception for the maxims of equity will not assist a volunteer or equity will not perfect an imperfect gift. So when the party was living, when the donor was living, donor has made this gift without satisfying the form, without satisfying the rules of transferring the property to another person. But since it has been made in contemplation of the death, it is recognized as a valid exception if the other valid requirements have been satisfied. Generally, for a testamentary gift to be satisfied or valid, it must be a gift which was made from the last will. So if the last will is in accordance with the Section 9 Wills Act only, the testamentary gift will be recognized as a valid gift. But here in this scenario, when the person is about to die, he has made a gift without going through any of the formal requirements which is necessary to make his last will valid. He has made a gift, but still for all it will be recognized as an exception and recognized as a valid gift if the three requirements mentioned in this latest case law in 2015 King against the Brave have been satisfied. The old requirements were also the same, which came from the Cain against Moon case law. Three requirements are, first one is in the blue cage, second one is in the red one, and the third one is in the green cage. As per the first requirement, if the bequest is made in contemplation of imminent death, this means the donor would have made the gift in contemplation of the death. That means not the mere death that we all face. We all know that we are going to die one day. So thinking that we will die and granting a gift is not recognized under this category. This must be a scenario where the person is facing a real threat to his life. There is no assurance that he is going to pass that particular moment and live longer. For example, if he is undergoing a very severe operation where there is no assurance of succeeding the operation, or maybe that he has faced a very serious accident where he is fighting with his last breath right now. So if he is in his deathbed in that particular way, then only we can consider it as a gift which is made in contemplation of the death. But if the person is going to make a gift when he was about to suicide, that is not recognized as valid. Second requirement is if the bequest is made contingent on death. That means this particular gift will not come into existence if the donor didn't die. If donor didn't die, if he recovers, the gift will again pass to the donor. If the donor dies only, the gift will go into the hands of the donee. So it is depending, the validity of the gift will be depending, conditional on the death of the donor. Third requirement is there is actual or constructive delivery of property. That means the means that could be used to acquire the property, the means that could be used to acquire the domination of the property must be handed over to the donee. At least the constructive delivery must be there. So that means it need not be the formal things that has to obtain the that has to be given to the other person to obtain the legal title of that particular property. At some sort of a delivery is enough. Some sort of a constructive delivery is enough. The means that has to be used to gain the dominant power of that particular property. There are ample case law with regard to this, but the problem is only with regard to the intangible property. If the property is tangible, there are plenty of ways of granting the constructive delivery to another person. These are the case law that we can use to show how the constructive delivery could be granted to the other person. For example, if the property which is in question or which has been given as the gift is in a safety deposit box, you can give the safety deposit box to the other person, to the donee, or the keys of that particular box or the password of the box can be granted. That could even be recognized as a constructive delivery of the property. If it's a car, giving the car keys to the other person will be recognized as a constructive delivery, need not be signing the formal documents and transferring the legal title when he is about to die. If it's a bank account, you can give the passbook. You can give the passbook to the donee. If it's unregistered land, you can even give the deeds which are relevant for that particular land to the other person's hand, the donee's hand. If it's shares, handing over executed share transfer form is also recognized as a valid constructive delivery. I hope now it's clear. Thank you. I hope now it's clear what is meant by donatio mortis causa or deathbed gift. Please subscribe to my channel to gather more information and more knowledge.